We've got some chipboard here. We don't know what the depth of the chipboard is. We think it's about 20 mil chipboard, and we think there's a we think there could be something under here like a junction box. So we're going to cut through the chipboard, and so I'm just going to show a way of doing it safely and carefully. So I've got my circular saw here, so I'm going to adjust it, the blade, to 20 mil or to approximately 20 mil, slightly less. So that's about there, and so I'm just going to very carefully just cut across the join here. And so I've not gone all the way through, but I can see that it's sort of getting there. So through, just because of pipes and stuff going underneath. Okay, and so now I'm going to use a multi-tool. I'm just going to cut through using a multi-tool. And just so then I can work out exactly how deep the floor is. Okay, so that's now cut through.
That's 20 mil, Matthew.
So I'm just sort of guessing where it is. And so then I can check on the blade, and so that looks about right. So now we'll go down a little bit further. And so now I'm just going to then go through the rest of it just with the multi-tool, because if there is any pipes that's very close to the surface, I only need to slightly nick them with the saw. So I can feel there's no pipes under that one there. Nothing under there.
Nothing there, and nothing at all.
So there's nothing there. So there we have it. We've cut open there, and so it's nice and neatly done. Again, just that caution of there could be pipes or cables underneath there, so you always have to be ever so careful. Okay, so what I was saying earlier about pipe work and stuff being underneath, if you look underneath here, I think you can see there's pipe work there, 15 mil copper pipe and some cables underneath, but you can see how close they are to the surface. And so that's what I mean by being very careful when you're using the saw, not going in too far. Again, you only need to hit the tip of the blade onto the copper pipe and you've got a problem on your hands. Okay, so now we're gonna put the floorboard back in. And so we've just got some roofing batten here. And so we're gonna screw those in and then make this a nice neat job. So again, what we do, we want the batten to overlap a couple of inches either side. And so again, a lot of it is just guesswork, but when you're doing it, you get quite used to doing the thing. So just drill a couple of pilot holes. I haven't done that very well. I ain't got a blade, a drill bit in it. Okay, and then use some inch and a half screws. And then just screw them in. That's held in there nice and firm. That's gone in there as well, so I'll put another one in either side. Same the other side, so again about an inch or a couple of inches either side. Again, doing the pilot hole, you don't always need to do that, but it just makes the job a bit neater.
And easier.
And easier, yeah. Okay, so that's nice and solid on there. Again, just get rid of any bits of sawdust that's in there. And hopefully that should now just fit.
Upside down, Matthew.
Oh, yeah. There you go, so there's the groove there. And so that should just tuck in there nice and neat. And then we can grill that in as well. So, got, how many is that? Seven screws either side, so it's nice and solid. And
you never know it was there.
Yeah. And notice we've got a whole set of different sizes of screws, so we're using the right screws rather than just sticking any old screw in, because you often see sort of an inch or so of screw sticking out the other side.
Yeah, we don't want to do that.
So, anyway, that's that done.